evening. I go by J-Rock the God. You can just call me J-Rock. And what we got here, UBAF, it's our annual Black History Month celebration where GDQ welcomes all levels of speedruns and challenges from the Black speedrunning community. We're just here to celebrate Black excellence and Black joy. We're just here to have a good time. We got some great people with some even better personalities, and we got one of them coming up in a minute. But before we start, I want to remind y'all that Frost Fatalis is coming up soon, and we have 2023 prize submissions open now till February 20th. You can go to gamesdonequick.com for more info or use exclamation point prizes in Twitch chat to submit your prizes. And I'm not going to hold y'all up any longer. I want to introduce the next runner because I had a little bit of chance to watch this and this entire run while we were sitting here waiting. And this is a good one. So without any further ado, that Andy guy, what's going on with you?
What is up? Yeah, I'm that Andy guy. I'm going to be running a neat little game that I found on Twitter on an advertisement. It's got a little bit of jank, but a lot of heart. Thunder Kid, Hunt for the Robot Emperor. Wait, can I give you all the title screen? No. How rude. Anyways, I'm going to go over a couple of things before we get started, though. I'm just going to jump into the first level to show you. A couple of tricks that I'll probably be doing throughout the whole run. First thing is movement. Obviously, you can walk around left to right, but most of the time we're gonna be in the air. So lots of jumping and wiggling around in the air. For some reason, you go faster when I kind of do this number right here. So you're gonna see a lot of that. Second thing, there are a lot of platforms like this that are like too high for you to jump on. And I was like, wow, it'd be really helpful if you could jump off of walls or like double jump or something. And just so turns out that I figured out a way how to do it. So what you do is you kind of press up against certain walls. No, it doesn't work on every wall, but if you hold against this wall right here to the right, you see I kind of return to a standing stance. He hits the T-pose in midair. It's pretty sick, but you can jump again. Wow, I'm over here cheating. But that's another trick. I'm trying to think if there's anything else you really need to know outside of like boss patterns. I'll kind of introduce enemies as they show up because you get eased into it. My boy Alec, the guy who made the game. I don't know him personally. I'm just saying my boy because that's what I do. But you only have to kill 3 regular enemies throughout the whole run, aside from the bosses, and that's it. You could shoot someone else.
I think we really need to know is where he got that costume from.
Where did he get this costume from? You know, this is literally, as I put it when I first got the game, great value Mega Man. he jumps, he shoots. He doesn't get 3 shots. He only gets 1, and it doesn't even go full screen. Ain't that some junk? But here we are. He does well with what he's got, right? I do like the little lightning bolts on the side of his head, too. But this is my first speed game. I've always wanted to get into speed running, and this one, for some reason, stuck out to me. So I stuck with it, and I took the record from the other speedrunner who may or may not be here. Nontimidus, I wouldn't be speedrunning if it wasn't for him having a run already. So thank you for that. But I guess here in a moment, we can just go ahead and... Oh, wait. It's not shared in Discord? 1 second.
No, it moved when we switched channels.
Oh, shoot. Hold on 1 moment. Let me stream this.
But yeah, I heard him. We got a world record holder running this game right here.
We did that. All right, is this thing live now? I believe it looks like it.
Yes, sir. I can see it.
All right. Cool. So, yeah, I'm ready to go. I'll give you a countdown. We just kind of go to the level select screen, select stage 1, and we will get moving in 3, 2, 1, go. Nothing really special in these first stages. We're playing Thunder Kid. Haters say this game is mid, bars. Gonna do a couple of wall jumps here to get through this section real quick. Like, we don't have time to shoot none of y'all. Goodbye. That's stage 1. And as you can see, it moves really fast.
I was gonna say it moves like real fast and smooth.
Yeah, like you finish the level and it's like, all right, go. Next. Get in there. You don't have time for construction columns or whatever that is. I don't know. We just hopping straight to the exit. Now, this guy introduces bombs, my most hated thing in this entire game, because the trajectory is random and they have the potential to take two hits off of you in one go. So yeah, don't get hit by bombs. So where did that one come from? I saw an explosion through a wall. That was kind of nuts.
Yeah, you said they got a random trajectory, right?
Yep. Just completely random, and apparently they can go through walls too. And why am I missing the exit? That's crazy. So this is the first boss, Boxer Baron. He has two attacks. He will punch you in the face with the extendo boxing arm, as I call it. And then that shockwave attack that you just saw. That's it. No rhyme or reason. It's just random every time. You get to 50% health. He starts shooting extra bullets just to make you upset. Like that. And he kind of has a pattern after you go through each attack. So after he punches, you can land four shots. And then he'll jump to whichever side he's ready to go to. This one's about three. There you go. Just to get consistent damage. I'm getting bodied. I can't be dying on the first boss like that. What? So that's world one.
No, it's just a warm up.
Oh yeah. I really like this track. But anyways, now these guys start moving from left to right a little bit more. They're a little annoying. They're setting up picks like they're playing basketball. But on this stage, you kind of want to stay on the high ground. Ah, shot in the face. But that's probably the easier route of the two. And then you go down here, get to the exit. Easy peasy. All right. One day I'll figure out how to kind of skip a cycle on those platforms, because that's been plaguing me for a while. Same
thing. It might happen when you figure out the arcade stick percent, right? You told me a little something about that earlier.
Oh, I did. I'll have to go into more detail about that at the end of the run, for sure. Also, that part looks tricky, but you're literally just jumping in a straight line. No skill whatsoever. I'm just kidding. That's a lot of skill.
I was going to say, it's hard to walk a straight line. You expect me to jump a straight line? That's skill.
There you go. Ouch. Those bomb guys had me scared. But, as you've seen for like this whole world, we're once again taking the top route because we don't like bomb dudes. Oop, get up there. And here we have, at the end of this corridor, the first enemy that we have to kill throughout this run. And he takes four hits. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you don't kill him, you can't get to the exit, so yeah. And this is probably my most hated boss in the game. Once again, he has two attacks. Thank goodness he doesn't have a second phase, but yeah, he likes to shoot bombs a lot.
The bombs, yeah.
Just random, and nobody likes random in speedruns, let's be real. Alright, yeah, we want to see him do that little two-step into the bullets. I love it when you one-two-step. Let me see you one-two-step. If you know the reference, you're old like me. Congratulations.
Don't do this. We just had an entire run where we had everybody's bones aching and crunchy. We needed a break. We thought we was going to get a quick break from it. Here I am stretching.
No breaks.
Man.
No breaks. Y'all about to realize how old you are today.
All right. When Sierra said pop it and lock it, she wasn't talking about my back, you know? But.
Dang. Oh my gosh. One health. This is...
One HP in a dream.
I'm clenching the cheeks.
That's a speedrunner's mantra, right? You got this.
Oh, yeah. Hey, let's go.
Look at that.
World 2 down. All right, so we got the desert. We're just going to damage right through this cactus here because we don't have time to maneuver around it. Pretty simple stage, though. These guys don't move at all. They just kind of shoot spray and pray, if you will.
The good old speedrunner's mantra. Why? Because it's faster.
Exactly. All right, we made it. I can't see that dude. I'm glad I jumped there. And stage one down. So a lot of people would think at the end of this stage that this is another enemy that you have to kill, but I'm here to tell you that you actually don't have to. We found some cool strats. Actually, the other guy who runs this game did. And I'm just going to go ahead and take a death on purpose because I need three health at this next part. If you don't shoot me, come on, y'all. There you go. All right. You'll see why I needed that health shortly. Oh my gosh, I messed up again. Eh. This is still faster, believe it or not.
So taking the deaths is faster than... Oh?
Trust me.
I want to...
this guy right here takes 20 shots. And we don't have time for that. We can clip on the left side and go straight to the exit.
Oh, okay. You did that in two, though.
Say what now?
You did that in two health.
Yeah. Yeah. You usually you lose two health by going through there.
If you're really careful, okay. I see what you mean by you needed three.
Yeah.
Two you need. Okay.
If you have three or four, then you're set. Oh, this dude set up the pick for real. Come on, y'all. They're running some serious defense today, I tell you.
It's really helped that every level is designed in narrow hallways.
Yes. Very thankful for that. Not so much in the sequel, though. This part can be kind of tricky, too. Sometimes you get slapped in the face while you're trying to cross these spike chasms. Oh, no, we took our first death. I'll donate $5 for that. That's whatever. Maybe I'll donate $5 for each death. But, yeah, this world introduces lasers, as you can see. They look like bacon, and they sound very annoying. They sound like bees, but not the runner that you just saw do Shredder's Revenge, though. Also, yeah,
That sounds cool.
Oh, yeah.
I can't hear anything. I'm just watching.
Oh. So this boss right here, you just walk forward onto this crack here, and then that's it. You're playing Double Dutch with lasers. It's pretty fun.
You know, so I love seeing things like this, where it's like, do you think this is an entire elaborate design of, oh man, all these lasers, you think you gotta jump left and right and move everywhere? And it's just like, no, let me stand in one spot and casually press A whenever this one laser is coming, because nothing else hits me.
Pretty much. It's quite hilarious. And he switches it up every now and then. It'll just like spray a bunch of bullets everywhere, and you're like, oh no! But then you
like
just
that.
Stay
right
here.
On cue.
You don't have to do
and
squat.
And you just stand right there.
Oh, that boss is godlike. All right. So World 4 introduces these cool little wheel guys. They're kind of scary in some areas because they can blast you right into spikes, which it just looks funny. I can't help but laugh every time it happens. But this level is just standard fare. This is the part I was talking about. Let's say I got hit by that bullet on that first jump in this room. I would have gotten thrown right into spikes. Also, homing missiles are a thing. Just move laterally.
Like this dude. Oh, he's really throwing... you are not kidding.
Not kidding at all. There's the second enemy that we gotta kill. And he's gone. Get out the way, bro. Taking way too much damage. Alright. Not so bad.
Oh, more lasers?
This room right here is a problem. There is... way too much going on in this room.
Yo, this is a lot. It's a whole lot of spiky tires shooting stuff at you. This is...
yeah, it's a problem.
This is a...
But we made it pretty quickly. Also, you don't have to worry about colliding with this dude. I'm just going to show that.
Yeah, I was going to say, is that a translucent dinosaur or something like that? He's got like the... lizard face with the laser, and he just...
I just kind of phased through him. Can't touch him. Big deal. Also, that first hallway, you stay to the right side because there's a homing missile that comes through and just slaps the wall instead of you, which is great because you don't want to get hit, right? Also, in this room, more homing missiles while these guys shoot at you. But if you keep moving laterally, you should be all right. And I think this is the last part of the level. A couple of dragons shooting lasers and more homing missiles. Just keep doing your thing. Nothing to worry about.
Yeah, I see you warmed up now. Those are some absolutely smooth dodges all the way at the end there.
Oh, yeah. And this is another kind of simple boss, Missile Marquee, or Marcus, as we call him on my streams. He's got two attacks. He shoots missiles, just like his namesake suggests, and random spray and pray. But at 50%...
he's putting the emphasis on the miss part right now, man.
Oh, yeah. So, this is not good. All right. Oh, swag. Let's go. But, yeah, he starts adding the lasers after 50% health, and it kind of messes you up sometimes. Especially when you have those missiles coming at you. But he's being real nice right now. We appreciate you, Marcus. Goodbye.
That looked like a bullet hack. I don't know if I can say the other H word. Can we say the other H word? But sure, it just looked very, very simple with just, like, a back and forth, left and right movement. And like, I'm just gonna say, I really appreciate seeing speedruns and things like these where you could just figure out that most patterns can be
very easily,
very quickly figured out once you get it like down pat.
this was a level I was really worried about when I was practicing. That part specifically. Let's see if these wheels are nice to me today. Because once again, if you get slapped by the wrong bullet, you're going right into the spikes. And that's no fun. Yeah. You turn into Voltage Mountain Dew on them.
Well, the tires is nice to you. That means it's going to be a good year.
Indeed. I see what you did there also. Jeez.
Oh. I had to keep the puns going, man. I was trying to figure out where I was going to slide one in there.
I respect it. So more dragons that you can phase through and stuff like that. You got some bats. They're pretty awful. Why are bats always like the worst enemy in every video game you play? What is up with that? Programs, I need to know. Oh, there goes stage 5 too, by the way. Lots of wall jumps. That's my favorite stage in the game, so I kind of autopilot. Sorry about not commenting on anything. Yeah, we don't have time to kill that dude either, so we're just going to jump past him. Now, these shield guys, you would think that you'd be able to jump on them when their shield is on their head, but for some reason, you can jump on them when they're closed, which, you know, whatever, it still works, but just kind of weird. And let's see. Got some more bats in here. Hopefully, they're cool, too. A lot of times, I just jump into spikes. That works.
Is that an instant death?
Yeah, spikes are definitely an instant death. That's one thing I failed to mention earlier, but definitely a thing in this game, unfortunately. Fighting Mega Man style even more, I see.
Wait, his idle animation, I've never seen it before. Is he like shaking his hips?
Yeah, man.
Because we've been running the whole... Oh, he's just like looking around. He's a little nervous. We didn't stop moving, so I never got a chance to look at the idle animation.
He's kind of jamming, to be honest. Also, we got...
Oh, is that Chef Boy if you don't?
That sure is. The hat is pretty top tier. I do like the hat. This guy's a jerk, though. Unless he does that. That's the best of the three attacks of his that you can get. That one right there is usually the opener. There's a grounded hitbox for some reason on that spiral attack, which is pretty cool because you can get like 4 or 5 shots in. That stab move, though, that junk can go all the way away. We don't like that. I would like to not be a part of a kebab today, Mr. Sword Dude.
Don't put me in ravioli.
Ravioli, arguably the best flavor of Chef Boyardee. I mean, I never really cared for the stuff anyway.
I'm gonna have to disagree with you.
Uh-oh.
I mean, I respect your decision, but I'm gonna have to disagree with you.
What you got?
I've always been the spaghetti and meatballs kind, and I think I like the beefaroni more than I like the ravioli as is, but.
Okay,
the beefaroni. I mean, you can't go wrong with either. You can't go wrong with any of them.
True.
Unless it's the lasagna. You can go wrong with that.
Yeah.
But the other three,
never
yeah,
the lasagna. Also, this is the last world in the game. We're already here. It's pretty bonkers. Also, there's homing missiles here. I'm gonna die. There you go. How many deaths is that? Like 5?
I wasn't counting.
Oh, well, I should
have. That
been
was the
counting.
First one I saw.
Oh, nice. We'll take that then. First death, baby. Alright. Stage 1 of this world is probably the most irritating one to get through because they just throw bullets at you from everywhere, as you can see.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, we made it to the checkpoint. That's progress. Oof. How did I get through there? Now this one, unfortunately, we have to kill this weird... Okay.
Oh!
I got hit with the 2-piece combo, no biscuit.
They said no entry.
Nah. Alright, so yeah, 20 shots for these guys. We're not going to worry about the dragons because we can kind of dodge our lasers as we shoot this guy.
Somebody in chat asked how many deaths with that? That was the first.
If you don't... There we go. This world is cool because you have that you can jump up there and dodge all that mess going on. We don't have time for any of that. Alright. Got more stationary dudes that don't know how to turn when they shoot you. Stay against this wall so you don't get
hit. Walk to the side. They just stuck in place. Like, them boots must be heavy.
Oh yeah. It's tough being a robot. I wouldn't know anything about that though. I got a couple of robot homies though. At least that's what they tell me they are. Alright, so this... there you go. Okay. This one shouldn't be too bad unless these bomb guys just decide to drop the bomb right next to him. All right, we made it. And the last stage, really nothing to write about here. Just basically showing off every enemy you've gone past so far, for the most part. Except for the, you know, big minigun slot machine looking guy that you saw a couple times in the run. I think this is the easiest route. Maybe I can play through this game a little bit more on my downtime and figure out a better one. Maybe I can just find a wall clip that'll shoot me through the whole stage. Who knows? There we go.
Does he have a nickname? The construction guy?
Nah.
Can we just call him Construction Carl or something like that?
Construction Carl. Yes, I like that. So now we're at the Robot Emperor, right? The guy that we've been hunting this whole game. There's a spot right here that's pretty safe, but these wheels throw off everything. So you have to back up a little bit to kind of take him out. But yeah, that bullet spray is kind of a check to make sure you're in the right spot. At least that's what I've decided. But he looks like that nose Pokemon. What's his name? You don't know?
Nosepass?
Yeah, there you go.
I can see it. I can see the Nosepass reference. I was going to say he looks like discombobulated Lego blocks, but we'll go with Nosepass.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he transformed.
Actually, no. You beat the Robot Emperor, and then this guy's like, actually, it was me, the Pope.
The Pope?
Yeah, I don't know. There's like this other dimension.
It really is no Pope. This really is the Pope. Oh, we out here fighting disciples of God. I love it.
Yeah. We attacking and dethroning, my dude. Oh, my goodness. So, more bullets, more lasers. The music's kind of like oddly calm for a battle like this, but hey, I like it. I like the vibes I'm getting here. And I like how the homing missiles just completely miss you. That's amazing. It looks real pretty, though.
Yeah.
And time. 1750. All right, we're underestimated. That's all that matters. I did mess around a little bit, but that's okay because I set the world record down 4 seconds yesterday during practice. So, yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Now, with the rogue AI defeated and the robot empire no longer a threat, the long and difficult process of rebuilding can begin. Perhaps someday this world can know peace. Until then, Thunder Kid will continue to fight for justice. The end. Shout out to Alex Samos for this game. I love it a lot. I'm working on getting a run together for the sequel. I'm working on another category for this game specifically. I'm calling it Arcade Stick Percent because you have to use an arcade stick to run through the game. And for some reason, it is... you just like walk way faster. It's kind of bonkers. So
I can't wait to see it.
Yeah, I'll be working on that. I'm sorry, go ahead.
I was gonna say the movement in this game already looks smooth as it is, so I want to see how smoother it's gonna look.
It's chaotic.
When you speed it up. Yeah,
it's not smooth at all. It's like real jerky. Just like, you know, you're looking like there was some video I saw about the Flash video game, if that was a thing on the internet, and that junk had me crying. But anyways, yeah, shout out to everyone who goes to my streams and has endured me playing this game repeatedly. Shout out to Non-Timidus. He streams everything. Follow that guy on Twitch. It's Nontimetis on Twitch. And if you want to follow me, I'm It's That Andy Guy. But anywhere else, you can just search for That Andy Guy. If you know me for any reason, it's probably because of music, because I do that most of the time. You may have even heard my music on this channel with like Relay Bros and LC Remix. So shout out to them too. Oh. Y'all are some real ones. What else? Do I have anything else? I don't think so. Yeah, that's it. Stay hydrated. Brush your teeth. That's all I got. Thanks, y'all.
And wash your behinds.
Most def.
All right, y'all. That was That Andy Guy. Give it up for him one more game. Make sure you're giving Andy Guy a follow. Stick around because we're not done. We got more of UBAF coming up. And up next, we have Super Punch Patrol, Anders Any Percent, featuring, we're going to be done by Sonic Man 2005. And I'm looking forward to that as well, too. I just looked at the artwork for this game, and it looks beautiful. But once again, give it up for the world record holder of the game that we just watched, Thunder Kid. And that will be It's That Andy Guy. Make sure y'all giving him a follow everywhere.
Hey, thank you.
Yeah.